I could legit call my dad right now and be like, I know you're 15 minutes away, but you need to come get the daddy long legs out. But I'm grown, I'm independent, I'm mature, and I'll deal with my own daddy long legs. Hey tribe, welcome to HGDC, HGDesignsCrochet. I'm Heather and I'm 29 from the United Kingdom. This channel of mine is documenting my journey as a crochet designer, making moments and memories. If you are brand new, hi, hello and welcome. Thank you so much for watching and joining in today. It's really, really good to have you here. And if you are a returning viewer, yo, yo, yo tribe, we reached 1,000. Thank you so, so much. It's crazy sauce, absolute crazy sauce. We did it! So when I vlogged last week, I was like, we're at 995. And then the vlog went out and then I woke up the next morning and we was well over the 1,000 mark. So that was really, really good. So thank you so much. Thank you to all of you for being here and being a part of this. I just love it. Today's vlog is all about this yarny pile and this yarny pile. Today's vlog is all about my autumn and winter wardrobe. So just so you know, I am recording this. It is Saturday the 28th of September and it's something to nine at night. You should be viewing this, if it all goes well, on the 29th of September, Sunday the 29th of September. It usually goes live around 11 a.m. So I'm going to record this, I'm going to edit it and I'm going to get it uploaded overnight so you've got it for in the morning. It's been a long week. It has been a long week and I've done 54 hours at my day job. For those of you who don't know, I work in the legal profession. I'm due to qualify as a solicitor early next year and there's been a lot of work on, and so I took advantage of overtime and I have really cracked on and got a lot of work done. But yeah, I'm so glad the week is done, tribe. So glad. Today's Saturday. I put a shift in today, which I don't normally do. I normally work the usual 9 to 5 office hours. And one of the things that has been getting me through the last 3 weeks of extra hours has been planning my autumn and winter wardrobe. And in actual fact, the fact that I've not had much time to crochet or knit has been, and yes, there's been knitting, has been a good thing because it's meant that I have actually took the time to plan the projects and think about it. Usually I start all of the things and for various reasons they don't really get finished, which I'll go into. But what I will say is the 3 weeks have really done me good because I have really thought about what I want to make and what will fit in my wardrobe. So anybody that's been watching throughout the year, thank you, will know that I've been on a bit of a challenge this year in that my word was simplify. So I pick one word every year. This year I picked simplify, and with that I have purposely chosen to just reduce the amount of possessions I have. I have chosen to have less so I can do more. I have chosen to buy more so I can make more, and that has been a very conscious decision throughout the year. That did start because I suffered from some health issues for about 18 months from sort of 2017 onwards, and it wasn't really until the start of this, well, it wasn't really until about Easter this year that that really started to lift. And one thing I did find was my time and energy was so precious, I didn't want to waste it on tidying up or things I didn't want to do. And so I started to simplify then, and so I made the choice to have it as my word this year. I have got rid of so many clothes. My wardrobe is just there. You can see half of it in the frame right now. The other half is a little bit more of hanging space, and I've got one of those hanging sort of drawer, hanging storage that you can put things on, like a hanging shelf. And that has got like my underwear, my night clothes, my gym kit, it's all there. It takes up less room than this rail, this storage unit here. My clothes take up less room. I have still have quite a few shoes, and some of them are in here and some are in the cupboard in the hall. That's another thing that I'm working on. In all honesty, I'm pretty much ready to get rid of them all bar four pairs. I'm just working my way through doing that, and that has been really, really enjoyable, because I don't know about you, but for me, definitely, I would be doing laundry, or washing clothes as we call it here in the UK, 3-4 times a week, just because I would wear different outfits or multiple outfits a day. I don't really like doing laundry, I hate putting clothes away, and so I would leave it all in a pile on the floor, and it's the same clothes that I would pick out of this pile again and again and again, because that's the outfits that I would reach for. And so I just began reducing the clothing that I have. I went from a triple wardrobe down to this tiny little rail, a triple wardrobe with chest of drawers and more, and I've just got this little rail now, and it's great. I also had over 100 pairs of shoes. I did. And now this girl rocks pretty much 4 pairs of shoes exclusively. I own just under 20 pairs. Don't really need them. So I'm working on that. And so one of the things I really wanted to do is, as I've been simplifying, I've also been really conscientious about the clothing that I do have and where I buy it from, because I want it to last, and I want it to be a quality piece that stays in my wardrobe until I choose to let it go. So that means that I don't really shop fast fashion anymore. Before, I would go to like Primark, or I don't know, another high street shop, and I'd spend like a couple of £100 on lots of random stuff, and then I'd wear a few bits, some of it I wouldn't even wear, and I'd get rid of it. And I haven't done that in a long, long time, and I really hope that I never ever do that again, for various environment reasons and just because I don't need all that stuff. I just don't. So that means I've been a lot more thoughtful about where I buy things from, and that I want them to be a good quality so they wash and they last. I sound like my grandma, but I'm perfectly happy with that. I'm going for quality over quantity, and so with that, I have started buying a lot more secondhand stuff from charity shops. I get a lot from charity shops. I mean, this was from charity shop. It's a Topshop jacket. And then I buy a lot, that's charity shop as well. And then I like to buy a lot secondhand, or in the sale. If I am buying from a store, it has been sale items. But I'm sort of on a quest now. I've set myself a little challenge to either have a wardrobe either made of handmade, secondhand, or gifted items. So I'm really focusing on the handmade right now. And also, as I've simplified the amount of clothes I have, I've realised that I have a colour scheme. And you're looking at quite a bit of the colour scheme right now. And it's quite interesting, because I was watching the vlog from Stacey, I'll put her name down here, and she's done a similar podcast, and she was saying about how she buys the really bright yarn, but it's not what she gravitates towards to wear. And so I have gone and brought a colour palette that I will wear, It isn't the bright jazzies that I normally purchase in yarn, but fear not, I still have a plan for all of that yarn. So I have just done some laundry, washing, and I've just picked out like my four most worn items during the week, so you can see the colours. So we've got black, grey, khaki and like a navy denim, and then I have accessories that are pops of pink, but the only thing I was going to show you is my hook set. So this is like my staple colours. Can you see what's happening here? Yeah. So I know that I want to make a scarf, mittens for definite very, very soon. So I've got this colour palette here. So I've got, and again, this is all just acrylic. I love my acrylic blend yarns, and I know there's lots of hoo-ha because it's plastic, but I do think if it stays in your wardrobe for a long time, it's worthwhile. And on that note, I did make this accessory 2 or 3 years ago. It's still in my wardrobe out of acrylic. So I've got some black. I've got a lot of black because I wear 80% of my wardrobe is black. I know it doesn't look like it there, but 80% of my most worn wardrobe, 95% of my most worn wardrobe is black, and 80% of my wardrobe is black. And then khaki, and you can see that behind me. That's the Stylecraft khaki. I went with brown. It's not really a colour that I do wear, but it's a colour that I want to introduce more of, and it really went with these. I was walking around the shop picking them up like this, and that just really works. I went with this more bottle green. I love the colour green, and it is really underused, I think. I have quite a lot of it in my wardrobe in various shades, from olive to khaki to bottle green, and so I got this to go with that mix. Then this, I'm calling it like, I didn't give it a very nice name. I was trying to explain it to my grandmother, and I said it's like a washed out khaki, sort of like dried out baby poo or troll snot, and she just laughed at me and said I need to think of my descriptions a bit better. But this is like an off, I don't even know how to explain it other than dried out troll snot, which isn't great, is it? This is called, on the yarn bound they call it fawn, which is a much better shade colour. So they've got that, and then I love my tweeds. So I got Stylecraft Life DK, and it's tweedy, and look at the flecks of colour, and that really pulls all of this together. But, and just like Stacey was saying on her vlog actually, I do gravitate towards flecks of colour, so I have a very neutral palette. Her neutrals was more like the softer blues, grubby pinks, and like, not beige, but you get like the oatmeals and the parchments and the stone colours, and mine is more the blacks and the khaki greens. They're more neutral, but they are much more solid as opposed to like the more pastely spectrum, and I definitely wear like these colours a lot. I will usually wear like head to toe black with then maybe like a khaki green jacket, or I've got like a green dress here that I'd wear with like white shoes. But I do gravitate towards pops of colour, and those pops of colour for me are without a doubt pink. I should also add that in my neutrals I do wear a lot of grey, and I do have a grey here, but it's not going to be in this palette, but I do have a lot of grey in my wardrobe, and so that, I just need to find the right shade to go with this. But back to this, pink is my most used pop of colour, and I've got a few ideas of how I'm going to put these in my wardrobe. Mustard or like a green shade, but a pop of this. I don't have anything in my wardrobe that is, outright mustard, but I do have items of clothing that have the mustardy colour in or are yellow. So that's another colour, and that will be going in this lot as a scarf. And then more tweedy, more pinks. So basically pink and yellow. But then I also really like burgundy, and there is quite a bit of it in my day-to-day wardrobe, store-bought. So that's another colour that will be going in there. So what have I got planned? Well, so I just had this wave of exhaustion hit me. Like, I've been watching my eyes get droopy and droopier. I worked 54 hours this week. I've had 4 hours sleep last night. It's almost 10 o'clock right now. And then I was like, I'm hungry. I'm gonna go raid the kitchen for a snack. So I had 2 crumpets with butter and lemon curd. Fine, fine, fine. 4 mini cookies. And not only have I just spotted Daddy Long Legs, but I also then had a whole tub left over of Brussels sprouts that I cooked last night. Mm-hmm. So, as I was saying, I think, there's loads of projects that I want to make. Because I've had such a busy 3 weeks with work and whatnot, I have been planning projects. Just, you know, looking up the odd pattern, working out what I really, really need in my wardrobe, looking for patterns. I've looked at free and paid for patterns. So some of the like objects, items that I have identified that I could really, that I would really like to add to my wardrobe are socks. Socks, socks, socks. I love, and I always have done, loved socks, and I have always worn statement socks, and then that sort of stopped, and I can't quite put my finger on when that did stop. So yeah, I want to wear more hand knitted socks. I love seeing socks with Doc Martens, socks and docks, socks and heels. I want knee high and thigh high socks. I want all the socks. So I've got like sock yarn combinations here. So I've got this grey, and I just want to put like a pop of this bright colour. I want a lot more neutral pairs of socks to add in, because the few that I have made have been quite bright, and I don't always like to have them on show unless it's intentional. So I would really like some grey, some black, and some more, where's my yarn gone? More like this colour, and here's one, this colour, which goes with this lot, so I'm going to add that in. And I have been looking at patterns. I've printed off quite a few in black and white that were free on Ravelry, and they're all in plastic wallets to go in my folder. But I'll read out some of the names and I'll put them on the screen. There's the marshmallow socks, and they are from Novita Knits. And they're like a really cute pink cabled sock, and it is in black and white here, so there's no point me showing you. I will put it on the screen. But it's a really nice cabled sock, and they do look like fluffy marshmallows, and they would be really cute to wear in and around the house. And maybe in a pair of docks, and I really like to wear layers, so I like to wear tights with knee-high or thigh-high socks. I really like my patterned tights, knitted tights, all the tights. And then I would put a dress and a cardigan, or maybe even a crop jumper and a cardigan. You can never have too many layers because you can take them off, but if you're cold, that's it. Your day's ruined. I don't like being cold. Ruined is an exaggeration, but you get my gist. Then there's also this pair of cabled heart socks. Again, I'll put them on the screen. So they are just below the knee. If I'm looking that way, it's because there's a huge Daddy Long Legs crawling its way up my wall. If it comes near my yarn, I'm just going to be like, what? I think that little bit there is the intro. It's moving. I could legit call my dad right now and be like, you know you're 15 minutes away, but you need to come get the daddy long legs out. But I'm grown, I'm independent, I'm mature, and I'll deal with my own daddy long legs. So as I was saying, before getting distracted, oh, it's buzzed off somewhere. Cable heart socks, they come just below the knee, and they've got a pattern of hearts all the way up from the ankle up the front of the shin. These use 3.5mm needles, and it's using, I think it, this is calls for Aran weight yarn. It's got its own yarn listed there, and I don't know what that equates to, but I'm pretty sure it is an Aran pattern. And I have 3.5 needles, which is one of the reasons why I was looking for Aran weight socks. One, because they're warm. Two, because I have the needle sizes and I have a lot of Aran. Thinking of making this into a pair of socks, as close to knee high or thigh high socks as possible. Pretty sure I have 800 grams of this, or near enough anyway. So I should be able to get more than one pair of socks if I wanted. Just shift. Don't feel very comfy. So there's the cable heart socks. There was also some long socks with cables on there, on Navita knits, and the marshmallow socks, as I said. Then I also looked at knitty.com, and they've got the very tall socks, and I'll put a picture in because it's in black and white. But they're thigh-high striped socks, and it sort of gives you a recipe of how to decrease and increase to fit your size. That uses Red Heart Classic, and again, and Karen Simply Soft, and I don't get those here very easily, so I'm not 100% sure, but I think that it's like DK or Aran again. And that use is 2.75mm needles. I have a set of those as well. And they're intended to be worn with like a suspender belt to keep them up. So you will be very toasty. And then I also got another sock pattern from the Anticraft, and it's called the name. I'm gonna put it on the screen because I don't know how to pronounce it, but it means little clocks of sand, and it's referring to the the emblematic hourglass, one of death's many symbols that alludes the passage of time and man's mortality. The symbol for affinity borrows this image too, and is a little hourglass on its side. Oh my goodness, now I've got something in my eye. I get hunger pains so bad I think I'm gonna pass out. I've got a daddy long legs buzzing around there threatening to get me. And then I randomly get something in my eye. I'll be right back. Sorted. So yes, lots of sock patterns. I also have sock patterns in mind for a lot of the 4-ply yarn that I've got to make socks. Obviously, such as these. I really want to make like a full grey pair with a just tiny little bit of pink on the cuff, and I've got a lot of bright coloured sock yarn, as you may well know. If you go back and look at my Edinburgh Yarn Festival vlog, you'll see where I bought the majority of it, and I was thinking, should I de-stash it, but I do genuinely love these bright colours, and I think what needs to happen is I will just put the tiniest, littlest bit in a project, which means I've got enough bright yarn to last me a lifetime, because I have something like 25 of these skeins, because originally I was going to make a blanket, but now I'm all about the garments and I don't want to make a blanket out of, well, never say never, but right now I'd rather put these into something wearable. So I have earmarked, or reminded myself, made a mental note to get more neutral yarn for socks. I am going to the Nottingham Yarn Expo in November. So whilst I've been planning these projects, it's also been great because I'm thinking of all of the yarn that I would like to purchase when I'm there. And it's strange because it's going to be such a different haul from what I got from when I went to Edinburgh Yarn Festival. That was like the first major yarn festival I went to, and I brought these times like 24, of which is just here. Oh, let me grab it. Okay, this is the sock yarn tub, and I went crazy and brought all of these minis and more. There are so many more. This entire tub is full of sock yarn. And so I have a lot of bright colours that I can put in, and I will make a couple of brightly coloured pairs of socks that I will just do in a plain pattern. And the more neutrals I will be going for, I'll do a couple of plain pairs, but I'll probably do more like cabled or textured. Now I know it sounds like I'm saying I want a simple wardrobe and then I want to make all the socks. I'm not planning on having hundreds of pairs, but there will probably be quite a few pairs, and I'm okay with that. Practice, experience, and just, I love socks. Out of all of my hanging storage, the biggest tub, like the biggest shelf, is for socks, and I only have two pairs that I have made in there. All the rest are store bought. I honestly, socks are such a thing for me, so I'm gonna start indulging again and making them crocheted and knitted. Thigh high, knee high, shorties, ankle socks, frilly ones, for docks, for heels, all the socks, 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 socks. The other thing that I want to make is a scarf, as I said, mittens, as I said, and then I've really been thinking about what else I need, and I really need a couple of cardigans. So every item that I make, I want it to be multi-purpose. Like, I like the thought of having knee highs that I can wear with, and you know, that you wouldn't know that I've got a pencil skirt over, and so they'll keep me warm at work. But then also that they can look quite grungy, which is my preferred look, not corporate, grungy, you know, layered over pattern tights and a dress and all the layers, as I said, and my Doc Martens, which I keep saying like I've got them. I'm going to keep saying it because I really, really, really want a pair. I'm making it come about. So I've got a pair of black Vans, like black brogues, which I mainly wear for work, and then a black pair of heels, and between those three, that's pretty much all I wear ever. And I just want to add in a pair of black Doc Martens, and then that would be my four pairs of shoes. That's pretty much all I need. So as I was saying, cardigans, I just really, really, really need some big snuggly cardigans. I want to make one in like a neutral colour that I can wear at work, which will still look quite smart, or that I can put on my shoulders in church, but then also one that I can just slug on over a load of layers and my Doc Martens and stomp about. Multifunctional, multi-use, definitely. Before I go too far, one pair of socks that I didn't show you, and it's these. Now, I named these Lacy Fern, and it's the sock pattern that I started to make myself, and I stopped because I didn't know what heel to put in. Heels have been a nemesis. I love this pattern. I love the detail, and I made this up myself, and I really, really like it, and it's something I'd like to pick up again. And I put it on my foot, and the yarn is just so lovely, so, so lovely. It actually came out of one of my sock boxes that I did a few years back, because I started doing subscription kits for socks, and it is something I would love to do again because I love socks. So, yes, I'd like to get back to them, and I'd like to have a pair of socks solely out of that colour, and then like rock a green jumper in this, and I know the different shades, but I could totally rock that. Oh yeah. So I really want cardigans, and I really want like jumpers or sweaters, depending on where you're from. And another thing that I've identified in my style is that I really like the traditional with like a modern twist. So I love the granny squares in like a modern silhouette maybe. And another thing I've really, really loved for a long time is traditional Aran knitting. And so I've took the plunge and I've cast on an Aran cardigan with the help of my nanny. And we started it last Sunday, and I'm using this yarn, and it basically looks like the troll's knot that's down here. And I've got the ribbing, or the welt as my nanny calls it, and I'm on row two of the body. I'm about to do row three, so that's what I have to show you. But it's going to be a nice Aran cardigan that I can hopefully wear with lots of different outfits, that will see me through from... There's three main outfits in my life, okay? Gym, work, church. And work and church are very similar outfits in that they're quite modest and quite well groomed. And then there's gym, and then I guess there's me on a chill. That cardigan will hopefully look pretty decent with like a pencil skirt, a nice blouse or shirt, and then it will also look good with, I know I will do this, I will have my gym kit on, and then I'll have like, I like to wear knitwear with my gym kit. I don't train or work out in it, I just like to wear my knitwear with my gym kit as an outfit. So I can see me doing that as well. I can see me having like a simple fleece type, jersey type material like this, can you see this? And then my cardigan. So yes, I'm hoping that gets me through the entire four different outfits I need in my life. And I also went through all of my patterns, and I've done it a couple of times to be honest, all of my books, which are just there behind you, and then I've got printed patterns, and they're in this huge folder, and it's so heavy, and I've been going through that and my books, and in one book, which I'm going to grab, it's called Vintage Knitting, and I've shown you it before, and I've also shown you this Aran cardigan before. That is on my make list. I think I'm going to make it out of grey or a very dark navy that's almost black, and I know knitting Aran in black is not a good idea because it will hurt my eyes and it will be difficult to see the stitches, so I'll make it hard for myself, but black is a huge staple in my wardrobe. I also really, really want to make an Aran jumper dress, so like the traditional cabling, all the stitching, everything, everywhere. I've also seen Andrea Mowry's got a cabled cardigan. I'll put that in. And then another knitted pattern that I quite like right now is this. So yes, that sounds like a lot of knit, and it is quite a bit of knit, but there's also quite a bit of crochet. I'd like to make the Sensum sweater. I'll put a picture of that in. I'm really annoyed. I know that as I'm editing this, I'm like, why are you saying you'll put these pictures in? I'm going to put the picture in for you. And I'd love for you to recommend crochet patterns that you think I might like to make, paid or free. I'm really looking for like an everyday sweater, statement sweaters, so everyday something I can just grab and go with like a multitude of outfits, and then maybe a statement sweater is something a bit more that I would just grab every now and then. So I'm really looking for some crochet patterns for a statement sweater, a cardigan. I'd really quite like a big cocoon cardigan. And then one other pattern I've seen that I like, and it is knitted, is the Agatha, and I'll put that in. So I think you're getting the vibe for my winter slash my autumn slash winter wardrobe and the colours that I'm going for. And I'm really, really excited. I've got so many designs in my mind. As I said, I'm going to make a crochet scarf. I do have this one, which is, the pattern is by Zines and Rogers. And you wear it like this. And I put this bit over me like this. And it's really nice and warm. The only thing with this is I would quite like to make like a snood, like a close fitting one that goes around my neck, and then maybe put this one on the outer side of my coat as a bit more decorative, just because I do really, really feel the cold, and so I think for me it's going to be crucial to to have my thermals. Like, I think this is the year that I'm going to invest in like a thermal vest and maybe some sort of thermal leggings or something, because I feel the cold so much. And it's one of the reasons why I want hand knitted socks, because they make such a difference to my body temperature and my circulation. Like, I've tried UGG boots and all sorts of things, and they've never really done it. And then as soon as I had my first pair of hand knitted socks that I made, just changed my circulation. So yeah, like, I feel like I just threw all of that at you, like, I want to make this, but I assure you, I've really, really thought about this. I'm not going to make all of these in one go. I'm going to make them as I go along over the coming months and winter, and I'm really excited, because now that I've really simplified my life and that I have less to do and I buy less, I have more and more time to make, you know, when work isn't giving me crazy overtime. But that comes and goes. First thing I'm going to make is a pair of mittens, because I had a set and I can only find one, which I'm a bit gutted about because I never actually really wore these. What I think I did is I had a mass D stash, and I think I might have caught one of them, and I've put it in the tub and maybe like donated it to charity. So I think I'll just rip this one down and reuse the yarn. And there is a great big hole in my thumb that I needed darning anyway, and a random end poking out. So I will rip that down and reuse it. I'm going to make another pair using a selection of this yarn, because although I love these colours, I don't want something as bright. I preferred the other one where it was black up here and I just had the pink thumb. So this is the first thing I'm going to start making, because in the mornings it's not freezing, but it is nippy. So I'd quite like a pair of these on the string, on the cord, to go in my jacket, my coat. Although it's kind of jacket weather, I'd like to have these and the string so I don't lose them. And then I really, really, really want to make myself a granny square scarf. And so I'm going to do that with these yarns. I was going to go for really crazy colourful, but I don't wear crazy colourful day to day. You find me in blacks, greys, blues, this selection here. And that's what I'm going with, though I might put pop of this in. I'm going to think about it. So I'm going to make that, and then if I do make it into a pattern, that will be a free pattern, and I'll release that to my Patreons and then everyone else after, because it will be really simple, straightforward. So they're the first two patterns I'm going to work on, as well as my Aran cardigan I'm knitting. I don't have a picture of that to show you at the moment. I want to show you, I just want you to see it build up. You can enjoy the surprise. And then the other thing I want to start is a pair of socks. But fear not, I have not ignored my crochet. The other thing that I am really, really, like, serious and set on is the amount of patterns that I have in various stages that I have designed that I've kind of put to one side. So, or not put to one side, but I just haven't got them out to you. So there's this granny bag that you can see here. There's Stella, and Stella 2 is here. She looks beautiful as well, absolutely beautiful. She just needs her lining and her popper stud and some fringing. She's so close to being done. And then I have my Enamored, and I have Inspirited, I have Pinnacle, and I have Promise, and I have Rhythm, and I have my granny square jumper. So the one that I'm picking up to work on is the granny square jumper. I really, really want that done. I think there's a couple of strands to this. I love the granny square and making it modern. I do think some of the projects I've made, because they're so bright, I know I'm not really going to wear them day to day, so I've not really pushed to get them finished. So I'm making the granny square in a fuchsia, the granny square jumper in fuchsia. And I'm going to finish it in fuchsia, but then I'm going to make another one in more of this palette. Not exactly this, because I don't want it to be matchy-matchy to my scarf, but very similar. I would just put in a couple of different shades to just, you know, boost it, because then I'm more likely to reach for it. But I kind of like that, because it means that when I get an idea in my head, I will use my really colourful DK to make it come about. And then when I make another one, which I tend to always do to test my own pattern really, or because I was just loving making it so much I furiously made it, and then I have to sort of reverse engineer it so I can make another one and write the pattern, I will then make that in the more subtle tones that I'm actually likely to wear. And the brighter ones I might put on Etsy for sale, or I might keep, I'm not decided yet. So yeah, I'm really excited to get all of these projects, like, not started, but I'm looking forward to having these projects. Oh, that doesn't even make sense. I'm sleep deprived now. I'm not going to rush to start all of these projects, but I am really excited for all the projects to come, and I'm really enjoying my Aran. One other yarn that I need to use is this. 100% wool, and I got it from Yarndale last year, and it's Aran weight. So I have 600 grams of it. So if anybody's got any suggestions of projects, I'd like a really special, I don't know, anyone that's got a idea, let me know. It's got this grey with flecks of brown in it. It's more the colour that I would put in with this lot, rather than this, which is just a bit too, I don't know, it's got a hue in it that I'm not as keen on. This is much, much more preferable. So if you've got any suggestions of any patterns for me, let me know. I'm going to let myself fall into my bed and sleep. I'm having a lie-in tomorrow, and I haven't had a lie-in in almost 3 weeks. Yeah, 3 weeks, because I've had so much amazing stuff going on, which I'm so grateful for. I'm so grateful for my bed tonight. So I hope that you see all of this very, very soon, like, get this out for you on the Sunday. I hope you've enjoyed watching it. If you have, click thumbs up, click subscribe. And I'll see you again soon for an instalment. I'll let you know what projects I've started, how far I've got on this, and the granny square curtain, because I know you're all tuned in for the granny square curtain. Tribe, it's almost up on my wall. Curtain pole. And on that note, I'm going to slide out of here. So thank you so, so much. Have a wonderful week. Happy making moments and memories.